Hello guys, this is yours JK. Today we are going to solve one model problem related to design of rope drives. For that purpose, here I am considered one previous problem from the University of JNTK R16 regulation and set number 3, problem number 7. Let's see the problem. Design a wire rope for a vertical mine hoist. Here we are going to design one wire rope for the applications of mine hoist applications to lift a load of 50 kilonewtons. With the help of that rope, we are going to lift a load of 50 kilonewtons from depth of 250 meters. And rope speed is 80 meters per second is to be attained in 10 seconds. So here the speed of the rope is provided with respect to time. Take factor of safety is 6. So this is the problem. Based on this given conditions, we are going to prepare a one suitable rope for the applications of mine hoist applications to lift the load of 50 kilonewtons with the depth of 250 meters. So first of all, write down the given data. What the data is provided here. Given data. Here type of, that means applications. So which type of applications we are using this rope for? Mine hoist applications. For the purpose to lift a load of, the P is provided here, that is the 50 kilonewtons. Okay, and after that, in the depth of, so what is the depth here? That is equal to 250 meters. It is also defined as height or length. And after that, the speed of the rope, nothing but velocity of the rope is provided here. 8 meter per second. And finally, we have a time. What is the time taken for that? That is equal to 10 seconds. And factor of safety is also provided here. That is the 6. So this is about the given data. Using this data, we are going to design a wire rope. So based on the given data, let's see what are the considerations we are considering here and how we are going to design a suitable rope drive. In the design of rope drive, the first step is here. We are going to find out the design load. So the design load is defined as denoted by P suffix T. That is equal to what we have defined? PR into N into KD. Here, what is the PR we know? That is the rated or specified load. And N is the factor of safety. That is also provided in the problem. But we doesn't know what is the duty factor. So how we are considered here the duty factor? Let's see that one. For the consideration of duty factor, from the chapter 24 in the old edition of design data book indicates the wire ropes. In that wire ropes, refer the table number 24.4. The 24.4 indicates the factor of safety and duty factor of the rope. Here we have a different type of applications like a fixed guys, auxiliary applications, hoisting system, lift stands, and cranes and hoist in general, hoist blocks. So here the purpose of this rope drive is to lift the load 50 kilonewtons from the depth of 250 meters in mine hoist application. So prefer the mine hoist applications here. In that case, we have a factor of safety between the 4 to 8. And as well as the duty factor is 1.5 4. Consider these two values. In the given problem, we know what is the factor of safety. In case of factor of safety is not mentioned here, at that time consider the factor of safety from this table and as well as the duty factor also, that is the 1.4. So here we know each and every value, n is given, that is the 6, and kd is the 1.4. Substitute these values here, we get the what is the design load, that pd equal to 50 into 10 to the power of 3 into 6 into 1.4. So by simplifying this one, we get the what is the design load required for that rope drive. 4,20,000 newtons. That is the value of design load required for this rope drive. And this is the first step in the design of rope wire. Go to the next step. That is the diameter of rope. So here how we are going to find out the diameter of rope? We know the applications of wire rope. Based on that applications of wire rope, first of all we are going to select the suitable type of wire rope for that applications. Let's see how we are going to select the suitable type of wire rope for given applications. From the table number 24.1, that indicates the general properties of rope. In this table, we have a different type of applications and as well as different type of wire ropes. And what is the diameter of wire and area of the rope, and as well as drum or pulley diameters in minimum and optimum conditions here we have. So let us see the applications here, mine hoist applications. In the applications of mine hoist, select the suitable wire rope, that is the 16 to 19 type. In that 16 to 19 type, consider the what is the diameter of wire and as well as what is the area of the rope, and finally what is the a drum or pulley diameter in minimum and optimum conditions. Using this type of wire rope, prefer the table number 24.6. It is the 16 to 19 type wire rope. In this condition, consider the what is the P, that is equal to 0.259 into D square. It is the way to find out the diameter of wire rope. Here, the P, it is nothing but the equal to design load. Here we know the design load. By equating this one, we get the what is the value of diameter here. Let's see that one. So based on given applications, suitable type rope is 16 to 19. By using this type of wire rope, we are considered the consider P equal to 0.59 D square. It is in the form of meter square. Here we know value of P, nothing but the design load. By substituting this design load, we get the what is the diameter of rope. Let's see that one. I think write the values obtained here. Nothing but PD equal to 4,20,000 newtons. Okay. Okay. Here we know what is the value of P. PD, that is equal to. That is equal to, it is in the form of meters, converting into mm, we get the 590 d square. So with the help of this one, what we are writing here, d equal to 4,20,000 divided by 590 root of 4,20,000 divided by 590. By simplifying this one, we get the value of diameter here. That d equal to approximately we get the 26.7 mm. So fulfill this one and consider the diameter of rope 27 mm. So this is the way to find out the what is the value of diameter. After completion of this step, we are going to find out the required parameters for the type of 16 to 19 rope. In the parameters point of view, we have discussed first of all wire rope, diameter of wire, and as well as the area of the rope, and finally drum or pulley diameters in minimum and optimum conditions. Let's see how we are going to evaluate those parameters here. So write down the diameter what we are obtained here. Diameter of rope, the d equal to 27 mm. Next one, we are going to find out the diameter of wire. Diameter of wire. So the diameter of wire is denoted by DW. So that is equal to same as what we are considering the type of the rope from the table. At the type of 16 to 19, what is the value of diameter of wire? That is the 0.070, and as well as what is the area here? 0.4 d square. And finally, drum or pulley diameter in case of minimum 16 to d, in case of optimum 100 into d. Consider these values and find out the parameters required here. That dW equal to 0.07 d. Here we know what is the d here. The d indicates the diameter of rope. We are already evaluated the diameter of rope. By substituting this value, what we get here? 0.07 into what is the d here? 27. By simplifying this one, we get the what is the diameter of wire. So that is equal to 1.89 mm. So this is about the diameter of wire. And next, find out the what is the area of rope. And next one, area of rope, that is denoted by A, that is equal to 0.4 times of diameter of rope square. So that is equal to 0.4 into what about this? 27 whole square. So by simplifying this one, what we get here? Approximately 291.7. So let us consider it is as 292 mm square. So this is about the area of the rope. Go to the next one. So that is the diameter of drum or pulleys. Diameter of drum or pulley we are going to find out here in two ways. First one is the in minimum condition, that is equal to 60 into d, and in maximum condition or in optimum condition 100 into d. So that is equal to here what is the d? 27. By simplifying this one, what we get the value here? 1620 mm. And similarly 100 into 27, by simplifying this one, 2700 mm. So this is about the diameters of drum or pulley in minimum and optimum conditions. And next we are going to find out the remaining requirements of rope buoy. So it's better to write down the what is the obtained values here. So here, what is the DW? 1.89 mm. And what about the area of the rope? That is equal to 292 mm square. Diameter of drum or pulley. In minimum condition, that is equal to 1620 mm. In optimum condition, 2700 mm. So this is about the requirements parameters of ropeway. Next we are going to see what is the remaining requirement parameters. Next one is the weight of the rope per unit length. How we are going to consider the weight of the rope? Prefer the design data book where we are considering the diameter of the rope. From the table, if you find out here 0.0375 d square, it is the approximately weight of the rope per unit length of rope wire. So it is denoted by W, that is equal to 0.0375 d square. Here we know what is the d diameter of the rope. We are already derived that one, 0.0375 into 27 whole square. By simplifying this one, what we get the here 27.33 Newton per meter. This is about the weight of the rope. For 1 meter, how much amount of weight acting on the rope wire? And next we are going to find out the remaining steps in the design of rope wire. Let's see. Effective loads. Effective loads acting on the rope. In the effective loads point of view, we are going to derive the loads in three different conditions. The first one is the during normal working. During the normal working, what is the force acting on the rope? But F equal to Ft plus Fb. Here Ft is the tensile load and Fb is the direct load acting on the rope. That Ft equal to Pr plus W into L. Here Pr is the rated or specified load and W is the weight per unit length of rope. And L is the what is the depth, that means what is the walking takes place with the help of rope, that is the 250 meters. Here know each and every value. By substituting those values here, we get the what is the direct tensile load acting on the rope. 50 into 10 to the power of 3 plus 27.33 into 250. By simplifying this one, we get the Ft equal to 56.832 newtons. So this is about the direct tensile load acting on the rope. Go to the next one. What is the bending load acting on the rope? That Fb equal to area of the rope into wire diameter by drum or pulley diameter in minimum condition into E dash. Here we know what is the area of the rope. 292 into what is the wire diameter, that is the 1.89 divided by, what about the drum diameter in minimum condition, 1620 into 80 into 10 to the power of 3. By simplifying this one, we get the value of FB. That FB equal to 27,253 newtons. So this is the bending load acting on the rope. Okay, here we know each and every value. By substituting those values, we get the what is the during normal working condition load acting on the rope. Therefore, F equal to, what is the FT? 56,832. Plus what about the FB? 27,253. Ultimately, what about the F here? So that F equal to 84085 newtons. So this is about the force acting on the rope during normal working condition. Okay, go to the next step. During acceleration condition, what is the load acting on the rope? I think it's better to write down the obtained values for further utilization. Here, what about the FT? That is equal to 56,832 newtons. And what about the FB? 27,253 newtons. Okay. Go to the next one. During acceleration of load, the FP equal to FT plus FB plus FA here. Here we know FT and FB, but we doesn't know FA. For that purpose, that FA equal to here FT into acceleration by gravity. By doing this one, we get the what is the FA. Here what we know, acceleration, it is nothing but the velocity per time. Here given velocity is 8 meter per second and time is the 10 seconds, that is equal to 0.8. So therefore FA equal to, what about the FT here? 56,832 into 0.8 by 9.84. ultimately, what about the FA here? That is equal to 4634 newtons. By substituting these values, we get the force acting on the rope during acceleration condition. 56,832 plus what about the FB? 27,253 plus 4634. Therefore, the F equal to 88,719 newtons. So this is about the force acting on the rope during acceleration condition. Go to the next step. That is the force acting on the rope during starting condition. Here FA equal to 4634 newtons. Which is the final step in the effective loads during starting of the load? The F equal to FST plus FB. The force acting on the load during starting condition, that is equal to 2 times of direct tensile load. 2 into 5, 6. 832 and FST equal 113.664 newtons. So this is about the FST. And here we know what is the FB. By substituting these values, 113.664 plus what about the FB? 27253. Ultimately, that F equal to 140.917 newtons. So this is about the force acting on the rope during starting condition. Next, we are going to derive the what are the resultant induced stresses acting on the rope. Here the first step is during normal working condition. Normal working. That sigma equal to sigma t plus sigma b. Here what is the sigma t? That is the tensile stress acting on the rope. How we get this one? It is nothing but the force acting on the rope by what is the area of the rope. That is equal to what is the tensile force here? 56832 divided by 292. By simplifying this one, we get the sigma t. So, what is the sigma t here? 194 newton per mm square. So, this is about the sigma t. And next, how we are going to find out the sigma b? That sigma b equal to bending force by area of the rope, that is equal to what is the bending force here? 27253 divided by 292. By simplifying this one, we get the sigma equal to 93.33 newton per mm square. So this is about the sigma b. Substituting these two values here, we get the stress induced in the rope during normal working condition. 194 plus 93.33. What we get here? That is equal to 287.33 newton per mm square. So this is about the our normal stress during the normal working stress induced in the rope. And next one is the during acceleration condition, that sigma equal to sigma t plus sigma b plus sigma a. Here we are already derived sigma t and sigma b, but we doesn't know sigma a. But sigma a equal, it is nothing but the accelerated force by area of the rope. Therefore, sigma a equal to what is the accelerated force here? Fa 4634 divided by 292. By simplifying this one, we get the sigma a, that is equal to 15.8 approximately. Let us consider it as a 60 newton per mm square. Here we know sigma a value also. Substitute those values here, that sigma equal to what is the sigma t? 194 plus sigma b is here 93.33 plus what about the sigma a? 60. So that sigma equal to here 98.33 newton per mm square. So this is about the stress induced during acceleration of rope. Go to the next step. So it is the final step here. During starting of row, during starting of the row, sigma equal to sigma st plus sigma b. Here we know the value of sigma b, but we doesn't know sigma st. That sigma st is nothing but 2 times of sigma t. That is equal to 2 into what is the sigma t here? 194 here. Sigma t is the 194. That sigma t equal to what we get here? 388. So here we know the sigma st value. Substitute those values here. That sigma equal to 388 plus whatever the sigma b here, 93. Therefore, that sigma equal to 481 newton per mm square. So this is about the resultant induced stress during the different type of conditions. So this is the way to design a suitable wire rope for the different type of applications. Do much more practice for different type of applications. It gives the maximum and much more knowledge related to design of rope wires. And this is about the today class. In the next class, we are going to discuss about remaining topics in the design of mission members part 2.
If you have any queries regarding this lecture, please comment in comment box, and thank you for your watching.